I'm John Papa.
And I'm Anders Hejlsberg.
Today we're going to talk about five things about TypeScript. Thing one, why and when will we use TypeScript?
Well, I mean, TypeScript is useful if you're writing JavaScript apps. And the bigger the app you're writing, the more useful it is. It basically delivers two things, you know, like excellent tooling delivered or enabled by static typing, and then the ability to use modern JavaScript features on down-level browsers through transpilation.
Why type in TypeScript? If you don't have to use types, right? They're optional?
They are optional, but listen, we all know that it's better to find the errors before the space shuttle flies than whilst it's flying. Do you know what I mean? And it's
yes.
Like if anything you can prove statically is better done statically than dynamically. That's one thing. The other thing is tooling. You know, when you're writing code in JavaScript, things like statement completion, how do you get that in a dynamic programming language? You don't know what X is. So when you say X dot, I don't know. I'd show you all the identifiers in the file or something. But if you have static types, you can actually deliver intelligent tooling. You can deliver refactorings that are guaranteed to work. You try to refactor a large JavaScript code base, and it's literally impossible.
I mean,
you know, once they get to a certain size, they become read-only, if you will. And all you can do is add more goop around them, but they're not changed like big things all over the place. Do you know what I mean? So with TypeScript, you can do these large-scale things to your code base and be productive and leave you to think about the algorithms instead of doing all the grunt work, you know?
I like to grunt, though. Is that okay?
That's okay.
All right, cool. I'll still use TypeScript.
That's right.
Thing two. What are the tools that you get by using TypeScript?
Well, with TypeScript, you get a compiler that can, and a type checker. And basically, the type checker can check your JavaScript code statically using types that are in your code or types that come in declaration files that describe the frameworks that you're using. And then it can show you like places where you're doing something wrong.
I'm doing something wrong?
Possibly. The other thing is TypeScript can down-level transpile your code. So you can use the latest ECMAScript 2017 features, yet run your code on browsers that are only ECMAScript 3 or ECMAScript 5 compliant. Because for a lot of those new features, there are sort of down-level representations that you can generate instead.
And we can find bugs with TypeScript at development time,
yes.
Easier than
yes.
We could as opposed to at 2 in the morning.
Sure. No, and that's the static type checking, right?
Right.
And then, of course, like TypeScript integrates into untold numbers of popular editors, you know, Visual Studio Code included. In fact, we built TypeScript so that the language service is retargetable. And TypeScript is built in itself, so it'll run anywhere that JavaScript runs. So if you can get to JavaScript from your editor, then you can actually implement and use the TypeScript language services. And so we have plugins for Visual Studio Code, but also Sublime Text, Atom, Vim, Emacs, you name it, like pretty much any popular editor.
It's fantastic.
You can use the TypeScript toolset.
Awesome. Number three, I've been doing JavaScript for 20 years. You're now talking about TypeScript. So who is this really for? How would you convince me to use it?
Sure. Well, I think, first of all, you could say it depends on the size of your code base. You know, if you're writing 3 lines of JavaScript embedded in an HTML page or whatever, then, yeah, you probably don't need TypeScript. But the larger your project gets, and these projects always get larger, right, the more useful it gets. And it's pretty darn useful even for small stuff. You know, the ability to get aids like statement completion and refactoring and code navigation and whatever, like even in a 1,000-line code base is super useful.
What's your breakpoint on where it becomes useful?
Well,
a couple files?
Like I said, I think it you know, it's useful from day zero. It's useful on a single line. It's useful even if you don't know that you're using TypeScript, because we use the TypeScript compiler and language service even if you're editing in JavaScript in Visual Studio Code, for example. And then, you know, because TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript, JavaScript is in a sense just TypeScript without type annotations. Do you know what I mean? But we have very strong type inference in our compiler. So we can infer a lot of the types, even if you didn't write them. And if you, for example, reference a particular node module and import it, and then you say my module dot, Well, if there's a declaration file for it, we can go find it, and then we can serve up statement completion for you in a JavaScript file.
Even so, we're getting the benefits of TypeScript, even when we're not using
exactly
TypeScript.
Exactly. It's the TypeScript technologies that are behind that, that power all of it. Yeah.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah.
Number four, when using TypeScript, if I'm not sure I want to use it, can I walk away at any time? What's the catch there?
You pretty much can, because TypeScript is just JavaScript with type annotations. And when you compile, we compile to JavaScript. And we actually labor really hard to generate nice-looking, pretty JavaScript. All of your comments transpose
into the output.
So I
would be proud of the JavaScript that comes out of it?
Well, a lot of people look at it and they go, well, this looks like JavaScript. Yes. I mean, because all we do is erase the type annotations, if you will. But if you're using newer features of a ECMAScript, we'll transpile them into, you know, old-style ECMAScript. But hey, you'd be doing that if you were using Babel or something else as well, right? So yes, you can walk away. But I have to tell you, I don't see a lot of people walking away, but you can, for sure.
But it's good to know that you can use it. You can transpile to any ES that you want.
Yes.
ES1?
ES3.
ES3, right?
You don't want to go to ES1. I'd put you back in the mid-90s.
Yes, so, it would. I don't want to go back there, although I had hair back then. So, number five, if I want to get started, where would you recommend we go?
Well, I would start at our TypeScriptLang.org, our website, which has a bunch of quick starters, documentation, demos, and also an interactive playground where you can type TypeScript code and see what happens to it when you compile it and see what errors we flag.
Side by side, right?
Side by side, yeah.
That's awesome.
And in fact, because TypeScript is written in TypeScript, meaning that it's JavaScript, that playground runs in any browser. It runs on your phone, even. Yeah.
I'll have to try that out.
Yeah.
All right. Now for a Twitter question. I got this question on Twitter here from anonymous user. How much does TypeScript cost?
Zero. It's an open source project. In fact, everything that we do in TypeScript, that the whole team does, is on GitHub. You can find us there every day. You can even ask us questions
or
log bugs there. Oh yeah, no, I'm up there every day.
So if people want to get in touch with you, just go on to a GitHub issue and have a good chat.
Pretty much.
All right. Another question from the community. How does the community also contribute to TypeScript?
Well, in many ways, but I think probably the most important one is definitely Typed, which is this GitHub site that collects type information for all of the popular frameworks on the web. And I think more than 4,000 frameworks now have coverage there. And in a sense, the open source community is writing down, you know, the metadata for programming on the web and collecting it in definitely Typed. And all of this information we can use, of course, when you're coding in TypeScript, but we can also use it in JavaScript because we use the TypeScript technologies to power our JavaScript language service. So if you're writing modern ECMAScript and you import some library, if we can find the types for it on definitely typed, then we can just auto-provision those and then give you statement completion and all, you know, and documentation that describes what the methods do and so forth. So it's a treasure trove, and it's all been created by the open source community, and it's fantastic. I mean, that is just sort of this virtuous cycle that's going there.
That's great.
That I think is outstanding.
And that'll help us with Vue, React, Angular, or Azure APIs.
I think there's hardly a framework today that doesn't have some form of coverage.
Definitely.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm John Papa.
And I'm Anders Hejlsberg.
And we just learned five things about TypeScript.